This gas costs $3.70 a gallon, and this gas costs $37 a gallon. What the heck makes this one cost 10 times as much as this one? Is it its fancy components? Is it all its additives? Is it because it's in a big old blue jug? Or is it all just BS? Well, today we are going to look at the chemical breakdown of these fuels. We're gonna figure out what ingredients inside here make it so expensive and break down the mysterious number we call octane. Are you the type of person to run 87 in your 93 engine? Or are you the type of person to run 93 in your 87 engine? One of you guys are doing it wrong. Let's find out who.
Big thanks to Raycon for sponsoring this episode of Bumper to Bumper. And now back to Jazz Yoga Dance 15-minute workout with your host, Jazzy Jerry.
You know, there are only so many hours in the day, most of which I spend nipple deep in automotive edutainment. But I make sure to never ever miss my 15 minutes a day of yoga, jazz, dance workout. Why do you think I look so svelte? And the thing that helps set my soul free in each workout is my everyday E25 earbuds, thanks to Raycon. These bad boys have up to 6 hours of playtime, have excellent noise isolation, and they sound just as good as those other premium earbuds. But here's a little secret for you fellas. They're about half the price of those other premium earbuds.
Raycons make a great holiday gift because it's something they can use every day for work or play, at home or on the go. And Raycon's being super generous for the holidays. So on top of their everyday great prices, they're offering all of you 15% off right now so you can save big on gift shopping.
So what are you waiting for? Head on over to buyraycon.com/bumper. You get 15% off your next order. There is a whole world of different fuels beyond the ones at your local gas station. Most gas stations give you a choice between 2 or 3 different grades of gas, each with a different number associated with it. Those are all octane ratings. But what does octane even mean? Well, in the most basic terms, octane ratings are how gas manufacturers measure how stable a fuel is. The higher the octane number, the more stable the fuel is, and the more pressure and heat is needed to get it to ignite. Now, most engines nowadays are designed to run on 87. The amount of compression in a standard base level engine in a car like a Ford Focus, for example, works perfectly with the amount of compression it takes for 87 octane gas to combust. The engine in the Focus can still run on a higher octane gas like 91 or 93, but it doesn't necessarily translate to more power. Those higher octane fuels are engineered to work best with engines that can produce higher compression ratios like sports cars or race engines. Now, there's also a common misconception that the lower the octane level, the dirtier the gas is. Now, admit it. Come on, you felt guilty about putting 87 in your tank. But listen here, you don't have to feel shame, okay? The octane rating has nothing to do with how pure or clean your gas is. Okay, that's all great. We know what octane is now. But what exactly would happen if I were to put a super high octane gas in my Catfish Camaro, which is designed to run on 91? Is that gonna make it run like a race car? Is it gonna shoot flames out the tailpipes? Well, let's see.
Now, 119 octane is designed for high compression engines. Engines that are 12 to 1, 14 to 1, even 16 to 1 compression ratios. Much higher than the compression ratio that's in my Catfish. And 119 fuel needs that high compression in order to get it to combust in the most efficient and powerful way. Ooh, yeah. Yeah, man, it's weird. It definitely feels slower. Makes sense, right? The engine's not designed for it. It needs more compression to be more useful, to make more power. This is why if you're thinking about going throwing race fuel in your car and going to the track, it's really not gonna do anything.
What about my two-wheeled buds? At the motocross track, there are always guys running expensive race gas in their bikes. Why is this happening? Well, a 4-stroke motocross bike is in the 13.5 to 1 compression range, so it's definitely higher compression. But even at that high compression, they're engineered to run on standard pump gas. So why would I want to spend my extra money by putting race gas in my bike?
And again, don't get it confused. Octane, no matter how high, has very little to do with horsepower rating. For instance, the fuel I'm using in this bike, it has 8%
oxygen content. 8%, that's about double what you get in pump gas. And pump gas varies wildly from station to station, from even the day of the week when you get it. So when you pay for race fuel, you know you're getting the same formula every time you go buy a jug of it.
But this fuel still costs a whole heck of a lot more. So what gives? Now, one of the reasons is because of additives. Every additive has a different purpose, and most of them fall into one of these categories: oxygenates, detergents, and antioxidants. Now, oxygenates are compounds that contain oxygen. More oxygen in the fuel means better vaporization, better combustion, and reduced emissions. Now, some of the more common oxygenates you've probably heard of are alcohols like methanol, ethanol, and butanol. High quality oxygenates can really drive up the price of gas. Now, antioxidants are different from oxygenates. And you might be asking yourself, hey Jeremy, why do they add oxygen only to take it away? Well, to you I say, my name isn't Jeremy, it's Jeremiah, and antioxidants serve an entirely different purpose. They inhibit the oxidation of gas over time, which degrades it. Now, I know everyone has probably seen the movie Battlefield Earth, it's classic, and if you remember that scene where they find a 1,000-year-old jet that still has fuel in it and it starts up, like no problem. Well, that wouldn't really work in real life because the exposure to oxygen over time would render the gas ineffective. Now, detergents do exactly what they sound like. They clean your engine. One example of a gasoline with a detergent is Shell V-Power Nitro Plus. Now, the nitro in the name means that this gas is nitrogen enhanced, which is just one of a few components that help strip the internals in your engine of grime and carbon buildup. One of the more common additives, at least back in the day, before environmental regulations, was lead. Tetraethyl lead, to be exact, or TEL for short. It's less common nowadays, but you can still find lead in many different race fuels. And when you start talking about racing fuels, that's when you start seeing the prices really go up. But what is in race gas that can make it more expensive than what you find at the pump? VP Racing Fuels makes about 80 different bespoke blends of fuel. They make fuels for two-stroke motorcycle engines and four-stroke car engines, each with a different but specific purpose. The more specified they get, the smaller the window is for combustion. That's when fuels start to get really, really expensive. Makes sense. I mean, if you have a fuel that's highly specified for one task, like a tuned two-stroke dirt bike engine or drifting or even top fuel drag racing, those are super, super specific. So there's no room for error. The octane levels have to be just right in order to delay combustion until just the right time. Now, VP starts out with a very high grade base stock, which is refined at a major oil manufacturer's facility, specifically for VP. This is the gasoline that's of way higher quality than anything you're gonna find at the gas station pump. And it provides a pure, high quality base for manufacturers like VP to make their own proprietary blends. The base stock is extracted using alkylation, a refining process that takes light hydrocarbon gases like butene and isobutene and combines them to make heavier hydrocarbons like isooctane. Now, the final product, an alkylate, is great for making gas blends because it's got a high octane rating and it doesn't contain compounds like sulfur or benzene, which are pretty detrimental to the environment and your health. You don't want to breathe that stuff in. But alkylation takes longer than the other refining processes like distillation, and it also costs more, which is reflected in the price that consumers pay. Now, if you want to talk specifics, which is why you probably clicked on this video, here is the chemical makeup of a race fuel that costs 10 times that of pump gas. This is MR Pro 6, and it cost $37 a gallon, and man, can you smell that expensive smell? If you've never smelled race gas, come on over to the donut factory. I'll let you sniff my can. 78 to 83% of what makes up this gas is a blend of aliphatic and aromatic hydrocarbons. And this just means that that's what our base stock is. The 17 to 24% of it is methyl tert-butyl ether, which is abbreviated as MTBE. MTBE increases oxygen and octane levels in gasoline. It's actually been banned in pump gas, but in race fuel, it's still used today. Now, this blend is designed to generate the maximum amount of horsepower from a four-stroke engine specifically. The high percentage of MTBE is one factor that adds to its high price, but it's not the only expensive additive. It contains isooctane, which is a product of the alkylation process we talked about earlier. It's in there to boost the octane rating even more and reduce engine knock. It contains methylene, which is a hydrocarbon that vaporizes at relatively low temperature, 124 degrees Fahrenheit to be exact. So in this application, I would assume it's in this blend to help vaporize the gas easier when it's inside the cylinder. That's what makes this gas more expensive. It's got a special formulation with special ingredients. That raises the price tag on this fuel. Not only that, there's always the research and development costs that drive up the price of race fuels. Companies like VP, they have huge R&D departments dedicated to creating special fuel formulas that offer racers a leg up on the competition. And speaking of VP, big thanks to the guys over there. They didn't sponsor this video, but we reached out to them. They gave us some of their stuff. I already ran this in my dirt bike. You might see some photos of it. If you're a donut fan, go check out the podcast, Pass Gas. That's where James, Nolan, and Joe, they go super deep into some more of the crazier automotive stories out there in the world. Thank you guys so much for watching. Follow me on Instagram at Jeremiah Burton. I post a bunch of stuff up there of me riding dirt bikes and doing silly stuff in my catfish. If you want even more access to more of the stuff that I don't even put on my Instagram, go hit up Donut Underground. Follow us here at Donut at Instagram, at Donut Media. Till next week, bye for now.